Welcome to another session of Optic Communication Networks, Unit 4, Access Network. Today we discuss about deployment considerations. Deployment considerations. Here, what is meant by deployment considerations for a network? Suppose we have to start a business. First, we have to, what are the considerations we have to take first to start a business? Here, what type of business we have to choose? What are the requirements? Suppose we have to business for water plant. We have to go for mineral water plant. Here, what are the requirements for mineral water plant? Nothing but we have to take what are the exactly water coming. What are the resources for that one? And where is the exact we have to fix that manufacturing plant? And what are the material required? What is the cost of that equipment? What is the revenue generated for every month? What is the power, what is the power bill we are getting for every month? What is the initial cost? That you have to take some considerations to start a business. Similarly, we have to build a network. What are the considerations we have to take? That is about deployment considerations. Here, we have to establish an optical network. Suppose the optical network, they are based on the SONET and SDH. Here, what is the abbreviation of SONET? Synchronous Optical Network. Otherwise, it is called the SDH, Synchronous Digital Hierarchy. This is the basic network to establish optical fibers. Here, how to design this SONET or SDH? Here, at the time of installation of our building, this SONET or SDH, right, it is a thing about transport network. You know the concept of ISO OSI layer model. How many layers of ISO OSI layer model? 7 layers from top to bottom: application layer, presentation layer, session layer, transport layer, network layer, data link layer, and physical layer. Similarly, this SONET slash SDH, which provides a transport network. Transport network. Here, what are the factors we have to consider to examine this transport network? The first one is, what is the growth of a network traffic? It is nothing but, suppose we are fixed, we have to design network for 50 users now. What about tomorrow? It may be increased to 100 users. That is, first of all, we have to design a network. First, we have to check what is the exact growth of a network traffic in future also. Next factor. Increase in domains of data traffic related to voice traffic. In previously, what is the use, the basic use of telephone network? The basic use of telephone network is only for voice transmission, but now it is also used for data transmission. The present days, we are using only for data purpose only. We are using telephone network instead of voice. Next, increase the competition. There are many number of service providers are there for data transfer, data providing, and voice providing service providers. That is either Jio network is there, BSL network is there, Airtel, Vodafone Idea. Different service providers are all are having a competition. Here, these are the factors we have to consider to examine the transport in a network. Here, once you have to build a network, at the end of the day, we have to check how much revenue we are getting. Here, for this, the mainly any network, first of all, that basically depends upon cost. How much cost to build that particular network? Nothing but it is a capital cost and operational cost. You know the concept of capital cost and operational cost. What is meant by capital cost? Initially, how much we have to spend money. What is meant by operational cost? Once it is started, how much money you have to spend for every month. Here, the capital cost is depends upon what is the equipment cost, first one, and cost of real estate. Suppose I have to drill the land for fixing this optical fiber cables. What is the cost of real estate? And how much power required to working up that cable? And cooling for every cabinet, suppose telephone exchange required cooling to reduce the temperature in the cabinets. And fiber facilities. This is the initial capital cost. What is the operational cost? for every day we have to go for some maintenance and operation. That is operation and maintenance cost. And suppose we have to take one building, we have to fix a central office or local exchange, we have to get a rental basis or lease basis. Next one is recurring cost for power and cooling. Every month we have to pay power power bill, right? Right. Next, labor cost. Nothing but for this checking all these things, we have to fix some employees for maintenance and servicing and provision. We have to pay some salary to that persons. That is also operation cost. And suppose if the network is fails, we have to replace that network. That is also a operation cost. Now we have to go for a check here, this one. This is exact SONET and AR SDH network. Here, see this one in US. Here, different cities are there. That is Seattle and San Francisco, Los Angeles, Salt Lake City, and Denver, Kansas City, and Houston, Chicago. Like different cities are there. All cities are connected to the fiber cables in a SONET or SDH ring. SONET or SDH ring. This is about main rings between the cities. Suppose these are the couple metro rings within the city. Number of optical fiber cables rings are available. That is the SONET or SDH having a ring structure. Here the previous figure which shows in number of cities in a network connected by a SONET rings, that is synchronous optical rings. Here the many rings are connected to a single point is called the stacked rings. Here see this one, the exact architecture of the stacked rings in a SONET. Suppose one city is connected to different cities in the towards a location by the stacked rings. See this one, this is a figure, exact figure, which shows what in the OLT. Here the OLT is the optical line termination. Up to this point we have to get optical fiber cables. After this OLT there is no optical fiber cables. We are using either coaxial cables or twisted pair cables or two wire pair cable. Similar here, this one, this is the one ring, this is another ring, this is another ring, this is another ring. Four rings, SONET rings are connected to one city from the different cities. Here from one ring to another ring we have to connect it by ADM. Here what do you mean ADM? Add drop multiplexer, nothing but connecting between two different cities through an intermediate city are releasing the connection, and that we are using ADMs. The ADMs are connected to different routers. Here the connecting between these ADMs, ADM to ADM by using DCS, that is digital cross connect, that is connecting between ADMs, digital cross connect. Here this digital cross connect having DS1 and DS3, that is digital signal 1 and digital signal 3. These are the private lines. These are the private lines. Here in the above figure shows the OLTs are terminates the optical fiber cables. Each SONET ring connected by using ADMs, add drop multiplexers. Suppose in our number of rings are increases, suppose go for OC48, the maximum speed is 2.5 Gbps. suppose the number of OC48s are interconnected, it is OC192, that is four OC48s. Four rings are connected to one node, then automatically it is called the OC192, then which is supports 10 Gbps. That is number of increases, automatically the speed can be increases. Here to connect between ADMs by using DCS, digital cross connects. Here these digital cross connects supports private lines, that is DS1, DS3, otherwise it is called as a E1, E3 lines, which are directly connected between ADMs. Here, this Sonitrix supports both voice and private line data services also, which having high bandwidth and which protects high protection and high performance monitoring and fault management compatibility easily. Suppose from this above Sonitrix, we have to increase the data traffic. How it can be possible? Here, see this one, the first one. Actually, these Sonnet rings are static rings, nothing but a fixed connection. Suppose we are taking OC48, the total rings is nothing but OC48 connections only. Nothing but it maximum supports 2.5 Gbps. Support in my future, we require high data speed. Is it possible? It is not possible. It's the first drawback. What is the first drawback here? The Sonnet rings are static rings. And capacity also static manner, it does not allow rapid provisioning of service at the end-to-end across the network. Here, next, second one. Here, see this one, two rings are connected together. This is the one Sonnet ring, these are the Sonnet ring. Each Sonnet ring having number of ADMs, add, drop, multiplexers. Here two rings are connected together. On a single point. Here, suppose these two rings having supports of OC48. What is the data rate for OC48? 2.5 Gbps. Right. Suppose the number of customers are suddenly reduced. We require only 1 Gbps is enough. Whatever remaining, it is waste. Here nothing but here the two rings are shared a common link. The protection capacity is reserved for each ring separately along the overlapping link. That means sometimes some bandwidth are waste. By default, all the traffic is protected, right? So we have to send the data or receive the data, we have to give the protection by using different types of encryption methods. Here, some services which does not provide any encryption method. Suppose protection is not needed for certain types of traffic, that is best for IP traffic, nothing but internet protocol. In sometimes internet product in internet, the data is hacked. Next, the SONET or SDH does not provide efficient mapping for many signals used in the data networks. Here, what is the mapping? Here, what is the structure? It is a ring structure. In ring structure, you have to transmit data from source to destination. At the time of transmission of data in a packet structure, each packet contains source and destination address. In sometimes, due to error providing that is a destination address, instead of receiving exact destination, received by someone. That is, does not provide mapping in sometimes. Next one depends on data traffic. Data traffic increases day to day. Here, before corona lockdown period, so some are using the data. Now, based upon online classes, the more number of persons are used for transmission of data. Nothing but day to day life, they increase the data traffic. For this purpose, each optical fiber line required high speed IP routers. It is some sudden increases automatically. We required more lines. Next one. Lack of management and signaling system. That is the technical persons availability for this servicing, management and operations are very less persons. That is the lack of management and signaling systems. These are the some of the drawbacks are in the SONET or SDH, that is synchronous optical network or synchronous digital hierarchy. Next one, we are going for architectural choices for next generation transport network. Architectural choice for next generation transport network. How to overcome the above drawbacks? We discussed, right? Around 6 drawbacks. How to overcome by next generations? How to design this transmission layer in the ISO OSA layer model? Here, see this one. The first method is using SONET/SDH as the common transmission layer. SONET/SDH as the common transmission layer. Here, see this one figure. This is the logical layered view. Here, this is the optical fiber cable. This is the physical layer. This is the different site services which are available. What I mean, IP, internet protocol, which is connected to P2PPP, nothing but point-to-point protocol. Point-to-point protocol. Here, where exactly these IP networks are used for point-to-point transmission from exactly source to destination transmission of data. Next service is ATM. What is ATM? Asynchronous transfer mode. Here, what is meant asynchronous transfer mode? In this asynchronous transfer mode, which are used to transmit data in different speeds. I think you know the concept of ATM, asynchronous transfer mode. That is, some lines are supports for 1 Gbps and some lines are 2.5, one is 10 Gbps. That is, different lines have a different speed. Next one is private lines, that is DS1 and DS3. Next one is voice. This is the different types of services, that is different types of applications are connected to a SONET. The SONET acts as a common transmission layer. Then all the above services are connected to transmit through a single optical fiber cable. Next, second figure shows how equipment is interconnected. Here the IP router, first one is IP router. IP router, sometimes IP routers are private lanes also, and OC optical communication 3C type and OC 12C type are connected to SONET. Here the SONET having ADMs or DCS. What is the ADM? Add or drop multiplexing, adding of all the services. IPs, private lines, voices service are connected to ADM, then transmit through a single optical layer. Single optical layer. And this is about the first method, that is using SONET/SDH as a common transmission layer. Next, second method is using ATM layer as a common service layer. Why you have to go for this ATM as a common service layer? What do you mean ATM stands for? Asynchronous transfer mode. Here nothing but IP service having different speed, private lanes having different speed, and voice having different speed. The voice having one in terms of kilohertz frequency required. What about IP and private lanes? It requires in terms of megahertz to gigahertz. That's why now the second method is ATM layer has a common service layer. That's why here see this one, the figure A shows the logical layered view of ATM layer as a common service layer. Common service layer, that is all IP, private lines, voice are connected to ATM layer. Next, ATM to SONET or wrapping framing. Here, what is the framing here? That is to transmit data in terms of packets. Next, connected to optical fibers. Here, the same logical layered view, how to connect in an equipment manner. IP router, private lines, voice connected to ATM switch first, ATM switch to optical layers by using either OC12C or OC48 or OC192, different how much speed required, that particular optical cables we used. Here, this why we are going for these ATMs. Here, it is more mature than the previous technique in terms of quality of service and guarantee such as latency and bandwidth. Here, see this one, the below figure shows the reasons for using ATM layer to carry IP traffic. Suppose we are using the service is IP, internet protocol, traffic we are used, that internet connection we have to use. At that time, how the ATM switch works. It is works in the virtual. That is the ATM working the principle of virtual circuits method. That is inside the virtual circuit, the virtual paths are there. Let's see this one, three nodes, node A, node B and node C, having different ATM switches and different IP routers. We have to connect PPP method, nothing but point to point protocol method. To connect node A to node B directly, node B to node 2 directly connection, or node A to node 2 direct connection, point to point connection. That is, the router of node A sees a direct virtual connection with the routers of node C without having go through the router at node B. You no need go for node B, but directly virtual connection, not a physical connection. This is a virtual connection between the node A to node C. Next, the third method is using IP layer as the common service layer. Using IP layer as the common service layer. Now, present days, instead of calling telephone lines by using WhatsApp, different methods are there to call by using data connection, you have to call the person one by one. That is a single method is there. No need for the separately voice transmission, no need for separately private lines we are using. There is no need. That is, now we are using IP layer as a common layer to transmit all data, voice, whatever it may be. That is IP, which is connected to point-to-point protocol, next connected to SONET or wrapping frames, finally go for optical fiber. We have to connect optical fibers. This is the how equipment is interconnected for using this IP layer as the common service layer. Next, IP over WDM variants. What do you mean by WDM? Wavelength division multiplexing. Wavelength division multiplexing. Here nothing but. What is meant by wavelength division multiplexing? Suppose you take one optical fiber cable. This is a multimode. Here the multimode nothing but more number of signals transmitted at a time. How it can be possible? Suppose in your class having say 16 students, all are talking at a time. I am receiving your voice. Nothing but. Suppose we are fixing an optical fiber cable from all 16 students to single optical fiber to my connection. Nothing but the student roll number one having some different wavelength. Student number two, roll number two having different wavelength. That is all 16 having different wavelengths. Then when it is possible to transmit through a single optical fiber cable. At that, how this internet protocol works for different WDM variants. Here, a direct connection from IP routers to optical layer is possible by using this WDM networks. How it can be possible? At this time, where is it? A large number of optical connectors are used. Nothing but a single optical fiber is available. All the students are connected by using connectors. Nothing but even number of students is 16. Suppose the number of students is 100. At that time, we are going for large number of connectors are required to connect a single optical fiber cable. Here, at the time, we have to transmit a data from all the students to me by the switched connection. First, we have to switch to on to first one, then signal transmits. Next, switch to switch, like switching. Switching can be possible. You see this, and how it can be possible. This is approach A. Here, see this figure, approach A. First one is router. What is meant by router? Exactly how the connection can be takes place. What is the path we are taking to transmit? Next, from router to number of connections are connected together to OLT. What is OLT? Optical line termination. From router to OLT, which we are using optical fiber cables. After this OLT, it is not optical fiber cable. Then it is connected to generate telephone transmission lines. Next, after some distance, it moves again. So you go for repeater section. Next, go for our destination sites. Here in this, IP routers are directly connected to OLTs. Here, pass through all the traffic at intermediate nodes is handled by the routers. Handled by the routers or repeaters, whatever it may be. Here, what is the drawbacks of this approach is high cost. Large number of router ports are required. And floor space is more. That is spacing for installation is more. Power requirement also more. And cooling issues are we are getting. That's where we're going for approach B. Here, see this figure, compare approach A and approach B figures. Some lines are not routed at the intermediate, that is, direct connections are there. Only some lines are required for the routing at the intermediate. Then automatically power requirement can be some less, power space is less, and some cooling issues can be less. That is, it is similar to first, except that pass through the traffic is handled by connecting patch cables between back-to-back WDM terminals within optical layer. What is the advantage of this one? Low cost, but inflexible. That's where we go for approach C. Here in this approach C, we are using intermediate access, the OXs, optical cross connects. All the traffic are transmitted through the OXs only. That is the cost it be in between approach A and approach B, and which provide flexibility. Why it is provide flexibility? It connects number of other nodes also, but in between in approach A and approach B, it supports connection between one to one, source one to destination one, source two to destination two. But here, source one to destination two is possible. Nothing but suppose I would like to call to our EC department. It is fixed connection, not possible. In some time I am ready to call to CSE department. But internal cross connections are there in between. Whenever in the intermediate cross connections are there, we have to connect many number of departments and many number of users we have to connect in a network. That's why it is a flexible. Type your query in a chat box only. Thank you very much for attending today's class.